Well, it's quite some time later now. Date in the lower left as usual. And this is all that's left. And here's the pile. This is basically what we've been doing. Basically just filling up the trailer. Cutting it out. Cutting out little squares. And then we'll take it out. And fill in dead zones in the yard. So like that's all grass from over here. There's another patch over there. You can kind of see dirt up. And then up front over there. You can't really see it. Oh well. Yeah. The next thing to do here is level it out. And then we can actually get the pool set up. Be nice. This is all going to pay off after all. Meanwhile, work is being done on the shed back there. I think it was a different color when I took the video before. I don't know. I haven't touched any of the footage since I got back in Texas. I don't even know if I took it off the card, actually. But anyway, yeah. I'm going to finish this sucker up here. That's my mom singing in the background. Get off. Feel dirt. Two hands needed. There we go. Still dirt. And yep, that's it. We're fixing to finish this thing after all. Yeah. 11 layout, the pool time lapse is now transferring. And I have had it up to here with this thing. Because it keeps wanting to fall off. Well, it's old. It's only been on the darn phone since I got it. Now where did it go? There it is. I'm talking to myself.
Okay.
Yes. I'm getting rid of this thing finally.
Oh.
Because it keeps falling off now.
When I broke mine, I couldn't move it. The last time you broke it, you couldn't move it.
Whoops. Okay, so this thing gets to die. Or not, maybe. I don't know. There we go. Now it's two pieces. Now I don't really care. So there. Good little knife. It's my good one. Well, not really good anymore. Because the screw is all stripped out of it. I called it a screw. Yes, I did. The screw is stripped. Of course, now it's not going to come out. There we go. Yeah. And it's rusted. Yeah, with the screw. I'm not supposed to just be able to press that in there, but stop making a liar out of me, will you? Yeah. Not supposed to do that. Okay, transfer is done. Now I can select all, delete, and accidentally turn my caps lock key on at the same time. And we can cue the build portion of the time lapse. We didn't get very far last night because we had to leave the thing out in the sun to get more pliable. Let the sun soften up the material. So now begins the build process. Well, we forgot something of decent importance. Filters.
Hey, Brandon.
What's that? You want me to grab that gigantic thing?
Yeah.
Here's the one.
Fine. So we're picking up some fluorine, we're picking up some filters. We've already got one, it's hot. That's all we need to know. Thank you. next-door neighbor provided us a pump for circulation while we wait for it to get high enough to actually reach the filter pump that comes with the thing. And it's just taking forever to fill up, pretty much. Playing with the pump. Yeah, I'm bored. Unfortunately, the time lapse is pointing a little bit high, so anything below about the third step, you're not going to be able to see until you get to like a little ways up the canvas a little bit. And then you'll be able to see it fill up, unfortunately, where it's at right now. I think it might be an issue because it's probably going to get dark before the camera can actually see anything. But it's hanging on there pretty well. Whoa, super zoom. There we go. That's better. And the zoom lever on this camera keeps sticking and I need to take the camera apart again so I can fix it again. I'm fixing this thing more than I'm using it, I feel. And the lens is dirty. That's a little better. I should probably just take the whole thing apart again. Wouldn't hurt. Hello. They always look at me funny because I talk to my camera. I don't know what it is. I don't know what the big deal is anymore. They know I do this kind of thing. Have a slow-mo. I hate mosquitoes! Well, I was hoping for a little bit more clear, I think. Anyway, that pump's still going in there, and Dad got up about 6:30 this morning, turned it back on. Now it's up to the third, or second step, I guess you could say. To the point where the camera over there can actually see it now. So that's nice. Still filling up. It's about 9:45 right now, I think, and yeah, he's mowing. This thing's all set up over here, ready to go. There are bugs hanging out in the pool. They can't ever seem to stay out. Anyway, next update when this thing is finally full. Should only be 6 hours. Yeah, you know you're a redneck when you're zip tying your license plate to your bumper. But My Alaska plate was zip tied there for at least 4 or 5 years since I got it. So I don't see why this one can't be too. In the meantime, I've got all my inspection stuff taken care of. Now I have both plates taken care of. Got a new battery. And I'm about to start working on this little problem. I'm just hoping that it actually was the problem. Because this one up front here is now making noise, and I don't know. This truck's just trying to kill me. It's just jealous that I was driving that 93 up there all winter. And there's a hair on the very far lens before the outer lens. Great. I don't think you can see it. Oh, it's off screen. Well, good. I'm not going to worry about it then. In the meantime, I'm going to fix the brake deal here. And I'm fully street legal here again. Yay. Alright, we are post brake fix. And it is not 3:33 in the afternoon. I never fixed my clock. Alright, brake check. Works. I don't feel like it's dragging me anymore. I don't hear anything. Good solid brake. We'll get her out on the highway, see how she does. We have success. The rear brakes are no longer dragging and making a stink of everything. Everything's working magnificently. And now, since I'm about 6,100 miles over, well, I think I'm 6,100 miles since I last did my oil change. And a year, at least, over. A year and a couple months. Let's see, we're at 131022, and my last oil change was, well, I have a screenshot of my little log here, right here so everyone can see, but I'm going to do one now, and it's going to be good, and it's going to be easy, because I've kind of perfected it. I've gotten it to a point where I can just whip everything up and not even bother getting dirty in the process. It's kind of funny, really. Like, the brake job was all over the place, disgusting, but oil changes are so easy. Like, I can knock it out in about 30 minutes flat. Well, but yeah, I make a little extra time for the pan to drain and all that fun stuff. But yeah, it's warm in here, so fans are running. Feels good. In the meantime, I'm gonna go for now. Alright, so we have a successful oil change, and this is more for my use than anyone else's. That's for my database. I do my maintenance records and all that fun stuff. I think all she really needs now is that second, well, she doesn't need the second battery, but she could really do to have a better alternator put in there, because at idle it still drops down to a little lower than I'd like, to be honest. It's still about 13.5 or so, but it could be better. Jeez, I need to clean out this truck. Oil pressure is good. The windows being down feels nice. It is currently 96 degrees. Ah, okay, that's it. I'm fixing this clock now. It is currently 19:21, so let's fix that. 7:21, let's say 22 just for the hell of it. Recall, disc 6, track 1, and we're gonna blow some music through this truck.